Welcome to Focus on You, my show. Yes, excitement. This semester, my show is going to be classy, sophisticated, quiche. We now have an antique juicer, which I personally have been using daily. I can taste the lead paint, and the doctor says I have 5 more years. But on to the juicy subject of the day, brought to us by the handsome celery stick of a man, Butler Wes. Come, Butler Wes. Thank you. You are a beautiful soul in a platonic and professional manner. Now, our subject today is... What the fuck, Wes? This is literally garbage. I can... God damn it. Yeah? You're gonna do the butler thing now? How about you do your job? God damn it. Okay, it looks like we're jumping right into our first segment. Focus on you, focus on the you, where we discuss what's happening this week on the University of River Falls campus.
That's right, Justine.
So how about you start us off? What's happening on the River Falls campus?
Oh, I have no idea what's happening on River Falls campus.
Then why did you come out of the wall?
Because I've been binge watching TV shows on Netflix. Right, guys? Yeah, 2017, right? Yeah. All right. How about you? Do you know what's happening on River Falls campus?
Okay, I'm going to be honest. I don't know either.
What? I thought this was your show. How come you don't know?
Me? Because I was out all week partying!
Ew!
Ew! Whoa! That's not okay. You can't do that.
You're right. I was joking.
Jesus,
don't worry about it.
Christ. Oh my god. Whoa, hold on. No.
Okay.
All right. Maybe it's time that we cut to commercial. Hello and welcome back to Focus on You. Now we'll welcome our guest from the UWRF Agricultural Science Department, Carrissa Herbrand. Hello, and thank you for joining us. You're our very first guest this season, so we're really excited to have you on.
Thanks so much. It's great to be here.
So first off, tell me a little bit about what you've been involved in at UWRF.
So many things. Horsemen's Association, Black and Bridle, dabbled in swing dance a little, tabletop gaming.
That's fine. So what got you interested in the department?
Well... Ever since I was a little girl, I liked animals, and we used to have cows at our house, and they were actually our neighbor's cows, but we housed them. One was named Chocolate, because it was brown.
That's a cute name for a cow. And that's also super cool, cows and shit. I love cows and shit. It's great.
Well, actually, we do a little more than just cows here at UWRF. We do everything from companion animals, which is like your dogs and cats, plus more. Horses, pigs, chickens, sheep, pretty much. And rabbits a little, I believe.
That's a lot of stuff.
Oh, yeah.
Well, speaking of cows and horses and the wild, wild west, we actually have a second surprise guest that's going to join us today. Please help me welcome Panhandle Pete!
Woo! 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 Woo!
Well, Pete, welcome to the show. Why don't you tell the folks at home a little bit about yourself?
Well, Jenny, I'm the rootinest, tootinest, boot scootinest sumbitch this side of the Rockies. I'm a fifth-generation cattle rustler. I've been taming wild steers since the day I could walk. And I'm as strong as 10 bucking broncos.
Oh, come on, Pete. Nobody can be that strong.
I am that strong. I'm not weak. I'm strong.
Well, okay. Let's get into some questions. I'm gonna throw out some cues and see if you guys know your stuff. Does that sound good?
Yeah, I'm ready.
Yay!
Okay. All right. Now you both must deal with fairly large animals every day. What would you say is the most important thing to know before handling these big beasts?
Well, probably one of the most important things is to know what their behavior is, and so that you can handle them safely.
Yeah. Wrong! Every mother trucker knows that the most important step to take before going out big-time wrangling is to chuck yourself in a fat dip.
What is a fat dip? Oh, God. Oh, my. You can't do that here. Also, that's disgusting. I would really prefer if you didn't do that here. This is a closed set.
Quiche.
Yeah. Okay. This one's just for you, Carrissa. When it comes to the equestrian grace of these beautiful creatures, how does one avoid having horses injure their suspensory ligament?
Well, in a nutshell, conditioning. Slowly build layers of fitness as consistently as possible, but never work them to the point of exhaustion. Other methods are palpitating the horse's legs before and after the exercises to check for heat and swelling.
Fascinating. And Pete, this one's for you. Any advice for any little buckaroos that want to be big grown-up cowboys just like you?
Well, I'd say things like don't squat in spurs, don't drink downstream from the herd, listen to your paw even if he's had a few too many. don't invest in golden guns because you can't trust your government. And start dipping early. Speaking of.
Oh my God, stop.
Nope, too late. Oh, we're dapper.
Oh my God.
Whoa, yeah. Woohoo, yay, yay, woo. Yeah, yeah. Woo, hoo, hoo, woo. Oh. Oh God. I think I swallowed some. Oh, I think I'm gonna be sick. I'm definitely.
Okay. This sounds like a good time as ever for a commercial break. We'll be back in a few.
I'm definitely gonna throw up.
You're about to be killed.
Yeah, I
want to
drive Zamboni.
Tell me where your fucking boss is, or you're
going
to die.
Yeah, I want to drive Zamboni.
5 minutes.
Yes, I do.
God damn it.
And we are back still with our very special guests, Carrissa from the Ag Department and Panhandle Pete from 1864. Now, something neither of our guests knows is that we set up a small challenge to see who is the best horse wrangler by setting up the horses and walking them around a well-designed and intricate course. Horses!
Oh, gee, what in the name of cow raised Jesus? Oh, God!
Okay, yeah, sure, I've done it a million times. Grab halter and shove it on. Yep, so work with me, hon. Ta-da!
Beautiful! Excellent!
Come on.
Well, there's one thing I know. That's not how you wrangle a large riding mammal. What you gotta do here is, beat him into submission, just like that. Get the hold on him, and you just keep working at him until they just... There we go. Come on. Come on. Yep. No, you stupid shit. God, come on. Come on! Making me look like a goddamn yellow belly. Come on. Move! Move, you big bitch! Okay. Oh, you're starting to get old Pete mad now. Come on. Come on. Don't make me. God damn it, you yellow belly son of a bitch! Prepare to die! I swear to God!
Keesh! Get off my set. Keesh. Jesus Christ. Okay. Well, we are swiftly rolling to the conclusion of the show and have to dip out. So thank you to Carrissa for coming in and discussing her excellent department and the cow-rageous work that she does. And thank you, Random Cowboy, for coming in and bringing a more sporadic way of doing things. Who writes this shit? Hope you viewers had a wonderful time staring at my show, and I can't wait to see you next... Keesh!
In the end, it's our ideals, our values that built America. Values that allowed us to forge a nation made up of immigrants from every corner of the globe. Values that drive our citizens still.